Now, really, this week we're concentrating on globe artichokes rather than all the other things. It's just like I say, there's lots going on and it's quite exciting. But this is a globe artichoke crown, which is a few years old now, and it produces these fist-sized flower buds in the summer months, which we boil and then eat as a delicacy. And well, the Romans loved globe artichoke. It's a big plant. Some people think it's a bit extravagant because it takes up a lot of space, but it gives you these wonderful fruiting buds, and they're a delicacy. And the Romans ate them because they freshened their breath and it made them all feel nice and clean after a hearty meal. But what I do with my globes, and I've got a line of them along this bank, in the autumn I put bits and bobs around them and I give them a bit of protection, because in a really cold winter, which we have just had, they can suffer quite a bit from frost damage. So just by putting some dead vegetation around the crown, I give them some protection. But now, I mean, there's bound to be another frost, but now is the time to just scrape this protective mulch away from the crown, give it some space to breathe, let the sunlight get in there, do a bit of weeding, because the creeping buttercup has tried to get established around here. Thing about this time of year, when we've had some soft rain, is weeding's actually really easy, because the ground is so soft and yielding that you can get your hands right in, and if I'm lucky, which I'm not, but I can get the roots out. So there, we've got a nice, handsome globe artichoke. These individual growths here, like that, we would call that a chard. And so it's got made up of lots of little chards. And I could dig this crown up and I could divide these, which I'll be doing later in the year, and I could grow them on. So from here, I could divide this into probably five or six different plants, which I could then grow on for more next year. But I'm gonna leave it intact, because I know he's a good performer based on previous year's experience. Globes will be productive for about 4 years, and then you do want to split them up just to keep them young and virile. This is the globe artichoke flower. Obviously this isn't edible. I've let it stand over winter for the wildlife value, and it's very prickly, so I want to be careful. But when this is young and this is green in the summer, you cut him off there, junk, and it's these things. You pull them out like that, and then just down this bottom bit, that's a lovely, thick, fleshy piece of the plant, and you scrape it on your bottom teeth. I'm not going to do it because I've got mould on it. You scrape it on your bottom teeth, and then you chuck that goes on the compost, and you get this lovely mouthful of artichoke flesh. And then, when you've worked around all those bracts, you get to the choke, which is aptly named because it is a choke. See, look at the insects in there. So that's why I leave them, because lots of creatures rely on this sort of thing for winter shelter. But unfortunately they've been disturbed, but they'll be all right because it's spring now. But you remove the choke, obviously of an edible one, and then you're left with this sort of round, thick plate, and that is the artichoke heart, and that just tastes like heaven. And as I say, it freshens your breath, it's beautiful food, it's a real delicacy, it's supposed to get the old blood boiling a bit, and that's your artichoke, and that's how you eat it. So it's a very physical food, you know, it's no knives and forks, it's all hands and fingers and margarine and, you know, stuff dripping down your face. It's good to eat with company. Well, we had a look at the globe artichoke down on the allotment, and I did have a packet of seeds in my pocket, except I can't remember where I put them now. Just bear with me a sec. Found them, they were in there all the time. So, I'm going to sow some globe artichoke seeds. Just while I do the boring bit, you don't have to sow globe artichokes from seed. As we saw down on the allotment, the crowns produce those chards, and if you lift those and split them,
then you just treat each chard as if it was a 1 year old plant grown from seed. So you kind of, you fast track the process towards edible production, but it's fun growing things from seed, and also if you don't need them, you can give them to your friends. So I just fill my pots. Oh, it's all going funny today. I've got a stick in this pot. So you fill your pots with general multi-purpose compost, right to the top, pat them down. The globe artichokes are a member of the thistle family. And if you remember that, then that'll give you a clue as to how easy they are to grow. And I sowed some of these last year. These are Green Globe. We'll try not to do any advertising. Green Globe is a very popular variety of artichoke, which is, I believe it's an American variety. Seeds are good. Another good one for young gardeners' fingers, because you don't need tweezers for these. They're sort of blue-green. They're plenty large enough to handle. Now, even though I've been growing these for a while, it's always good to double-check the seed packet. So for indoor sowing, trays, well, I'm not doing them in trays, I'm doing them in pots. It doesn't say how deep. Now, that's not very helpful, but if you remember the rule of planting no more than twice the thickness of the seed. So they're quite large seeds, so I'm going to make a hole about between 1.5 and 2 centimetres deep in the top of the pot with my dibber. And I'm just going to plonk one seed per hole. I don't want to grow too many of these, because unless you've got a massive plot, because they are quite space hungry, not going to have room for them all. Return the seeds back into the packet for next year, or to give away or swap. There's no point having seeds sitting at home that you're never going to use. You might as well give them to someone so that they get the benefit. And then literally it's just a case covering them over. I'll just do this one right through to the end, covering them over, firming down. Try and keep it looking as neat as possible. Don't rush this bit. You're going to be looking at these daily for a few weeks, so you want them to look presentable, and give them a decent soaking of water. Just control the flow so you don't disturb the seed that you've nestled down. And this is quite nice because I've been helpfully supplied with a label. Only thing I need to add to that is the date. So it's, I think it was the 28th. Is it the 28th? 25th.
I make it the 25th.
25th of March. That's just to remind me. Pop that in there. And that will be ready to plant out around the end of June, early July.